Okay, so let's start with the quality center. Alright, so first let's understand what is the purpose of this quality center. Okay, so you have already done the manual testing, right? So what did you do in the manual testing? You were making lot of documents, correct? You are making the documents like, let's say, the test case document, and then you made the RTM, correct? And also you are trying to share the documents in your team. Let's say you are doing the design and, you know, you are passing it on to your team member in order to do the execution, and then you were doing the defect reporting, correct? So all the activities of the manual testing you were doing using the Excel sheet documents, correct? You use the Excel sheet. And then when you had to share, you should either, you know, put it in something like a share folder, a folder that is shared with all the team members, or let's say you could have emailed it, right? So these were the only possibilities when you were doing the manual testing using the Excel sheet documents, and you were not using any kind of tool over there, okay? Then now we have something called as quality center. Okay, let's try to understand what is this quality center. Okay, so in this quality center you are going to store all the files in one common location. Okay, we call it as a quality center server. Okay, so in the server of this quality center you are going to add your requirement documents, you are going to add your test cases, okay, you are going to add your defects, alright. Even the execution can be done in this quality center, right? And when all these documents are stored over here in a common location of this quality center server, all the team members can access it. Let's say we have Bharti, okay, then we have Anita, okay, who else is there? Okay, so we have Vanilla, and then we have Deepti. Okay, so these are the different testers of our team who are trying to prepare different documents. Some of them are trying to use the document. Let's say Bharti and Anita are preparing the test case document. Deepti and Vanilla are taking those test case documents, and then they are doing the execution and also the defect reporting. So do you see here, all the files are stored in the common location so that everybody is having the access to it. Okay, Bharti can go and modify it, Anita can modify it, Vanilla can modify it, Deepti can modify it. Okay, all of them can use these documents, they can update these documents, right? So they can create new documents, they can modify the existing documents, right? And then they can delete the documents. They can, okay, so this is it, okay. So they can do all these things with these documents, correct? And let's say now Bharti goes and modifies some document. Okay, so whenever she is going to do this modification, it gets recorded over there. For example, Bharti has modified the test case document, it gets recorded, okay. So Bharti has modified it on so and so date and time, and what exactly she has modified, everything will get logged in over this quality center server. And whenever these people are going to log in into the quality center server, they will be logging from their computer, which is called as the quality center client. Okay, so all of them should have the quality center client installed on their computer. Okay, so they should have the quality center client installed on their computer if they have to access this quality center server. Okay, so they are going to use this quality center client, and they will be logging into the quality center server with their username and password. So each one of them will be given a separate username and password using which they will be logging into the computer or the quality center server, and they will be creating the new documents, modifying the existing documents, or deleting the documents. Okay. Is it clear, everybody? Yes, they can log in at the same time. Okay, everybody can log in at the same time. So quality center's client is nothing but, it is a software that is installed on the computer of each and every team member over here so that you can log in. Okay. Okay, is this clear, everybody? What is the purpose of quality center that is used here? Any doubts why quality center is used? Okay, can you see the advantage over here? See, instead of sending the email, or if we put it in the shared folder, who does the modification, who has added the new document, we cannot make out, correct? But if we are sharing here in the common server, all right, and if somebody is modifying with their name, we can easily make out, okay, so this person has done some modification, okay, along with the time, at what date, what time they modified, we can find out, okay? Is it clear, everybody? No, Deepthi, quality center and QTP are different. I will tell you later what is QTP. Okay, but what is a quality center? It is nothing but we call it as a test management tool. Okay, so what do we call it as? We call it as a test management tool because it is going to manage all the testing activities. Okay, what are the testing activities? You can create the requirement, you can create the test cases, you can execute the test cases, you can prepare the defect report. So all these activities of the manual testing, they can be managed using this quality center tool. Okay, so we call it as a test management tool. It comes under the category of test management tool. Okay, how many users can use it? It depends on the number of license that we purchase. If we have purchased 5 license, we can, you know, have 5 people who is, you know, who are accessing the quality center. If we have purchased 10 license, then 10 people can access. So it depends on the number of license that you have purchased. Okay. Yes, Vidya, everything will get recorded there. Okay. Okay, Jaya has a question, quality center and test director, are they same? Okay, we will come to this question. Okay, so now we have the different versions of the quality center. I think some of you have got installed quality center 9.0. Some of you had got installed quality center, something called as ALM, correct? So these are the different versions of the quality center. And the previous versions, you know, they were called as the test director. So test director or quality center, it is one and the same. And the newest version that we have, quality center 11.0, this is called as an ALM, application lifecycle management tool. Okay. And then this is 9.0. So the different versions are having the different names. So before it was called as a test director, now it is called as a quality center. And then the latest version, the 11.0, we call it as an ALM. Okay, is it clear, everybody? And the reason why they have developed this is they have not added any, you know, new features as such. I mean, not any major changes they have made. All right. It is just that, you know, for the compatibility, they have updated the version. Compatibility with what? Your operating system. Okay. So now quality center 9, okay, it was working very good with your XP. But with this XP, I mean the quality center 9.0, when we had the new version of the operating system, that is, you know, Windows 7 and then Vista, it was not much compatible. So we came up with the 11.0. Okay. So because your operating system version is changing, they are upgrading this quality center version so that they can suit the operating system that you are using. Okay. So ALM is nothing but it is application life cycle. It is a name, okay? Life cycle management. What is this again? Application means what? Software. Okay, sorry, I think I got muted. Yeah. So what is this application? It is nothing but the software. Lifecycle means what? The different testing activities of the software. And then management. This is again the test management tool. Okay, so they have given a name. application life cycle.